heard several rabbis speak that this is the last generation of Yeshiva. And I'm talking about Orthodox rabbis. I also believe that this is the last generation before the Mashiach come. I'm sorry, I've heard Orthodox rabbis speak saying that this is the last generation before the coming of the Mashiach. I also believe that we're living in end times and that Yeshua HaMashiach, who is the Mashiach that was prophesied in the Tanakh, is soon to come back. Hallelujah. No one knows the time or the hour, the day when Yeshua HaMashiach will return. It's this message is kept in mind and the heart of our Father. But he gave us signs to look for the birth pains of living closer and closer together. Hallelujah. So I believe that we are living in end times. Hallelujah. I remember when I was in Israel and I was told, the Ruach HaKadosh sent me to Israel to pray in the temple. Now, he told me to pray facing the east of the Temple Mount. And I spoke about this in another video, but I'll mention it again. I didn't know why he wanted me to pray. This was about a year ago. It was January of 2013. But I was obedient and I went. I remember it was raining. And I remember that before I prayed on the Temple Mount, the night before I went, I lit and I saw Muslims praying with their backs. They were all bowed down and they were praying not to the Holy One of Israel, but to their God, who is Baal. And their buttocks while facing the Dome of the Rock, which is where the temple, the second temple, stood. Hallelujah. And this place is very sacred to the Holy One of Israel because it is the place where he told Abraham to take his only son, Isaac, and to sacrifice him. This is Mount Moriah, a holy mountain, sacred to the Holy One of Israel. So anyway, when he showed me this vision, I could feel his agony that people were worshiping Baal on the Holy Mount and not the Holy One of Israel. And I saw men and women bowing on their knees with their face turned against the Dome of the Rock. And the buttocks pointed towards the Dome of the Rock. For some reason, I saw a woman with a yellow dress, and I don't know that that's important. I just remember that vision. And I remember the Spirit of Living God spoke to my spirit, and he said, they're bowing their knees to worship. On my holy mountain, Mount Moriah, not the Holy One of Israel. And he told me that when they go into the Dome of the Rock, they go in there to worship Baal, not the Holy One of Israel. and screams the spirit of the living God that actually let me make this career. I used to see the Dome of Rock as a beautiful piece of architecture. But ever since he gave me that vision and let me feel his pain and agony, I now see it as a detestable, despicable corruption to Baal. And what the Holy One of Israel told me is to pray for the destruction of the Dome of the Rock when I went to the Temple Mount. So I went to the Temple Mount and it was raining. And I was blessed because my tour guide was John Odom. I hope I'm saying his name right if I'm not forgetting John. And I was very blessed. He is the person who made the menorah that's in the Jewish quarters. He made it for the Temple Institute. So it was an extraordinary blessing to have him as my tour guide. And I had anxiety in knowing what direction was east because the Holy One of Israel told me to pray east of the Temple Mount. One of the first things Chaim did was he pointed and said, "This is east of the Temple Mount." And the direction he pointed to, he said, was the Mount of Olives. And I knew it was the Ruach HaKodesh because, as I said, I had anxiety in knowing which way would be east of the Temple Mount. So after he told me which way was east, I proceeded to walk towards the how can I say this? Because the Temple Mount is surrounded by brick, okay? So I went toward the area of the Temple Mount that was brick. And through the crevice, I looked through the crevice and I could see the Mount of Olives and I started to pray. And I was praying for the destruction of the Dome of the Rock. Hallelujah. And I was accompanied by Chaim Odom. I was accompanied by someone at that time who was a Facebook friend, and I was accompanied by a Muslim policeman. And when I got there, he asked me if I was a Muslim. I said, "No, I'm not a Muslim." And he had a rifle strapped to him, and he followed us everywhere we went. However, when I got to east of the Temple Mount and began to pray, I closed my eyes. And I looked through the crevice in the wall, and I prayed for the destruction of the Dome of the Rock. This again was in January 2013. The Dome of the Rock still stands. But I stand firm in believing that the Holy One of Israel will destroy the Dome of the Rock. It will not be destroyed by man. It will be destroyed supernaturally. So that everyone know that it was an act of God. Hallelujah. In my humanness, I wanted to see it destroyed before my very own eyes. But of course it wasn't. And it still stands today. But I believe that the Holy One of Israel will destroy the Dome of the Rock. Because it is an abomination to him. And I prayed this prayer and I try to pray it again today. He says, "Daughter, you have done what I asked. So now I just wait for him to destroy. And he will destroy it in his timing. Not my timing, but in his timing. And the third temple will be built." Hallelujah. I will never forget. When I came back that night, the Spirit of the Living God came upon me, and he put this song in my spirit, and it came to my spirit last night, and so I'm going to sing it to you today. Many times the Ruach HaKodesh speaks to me in song, and this is the song that he gave me after I completed my mission in Temple Mount. Come, Shea, come, Shea, come, Shea, come. Come, Shea, come, Shea, come, Shea, come. Here I come. Come, share, come. He's coming back with the clouds. Come, share, come. Come, share. Yeshua HaMashiach. Yeshua HaMashiach. Shanta. Yeshua HaMashiach. He's coming back with the clouds. Come, share. Come share. That's the song that the Ruach HaKodesh put in my spirit. The night I completed my mission on the Temple Mount to pray for the destruction of the Dome of the Rock. And I haven't forgotten the prayer he told me. And then sometimes I try to pray again, but still standing. Because I'm bigger than my own humanness. The Ruach HaKodesh tells my spirit, daughter, you have done what I've asked you to do. The rest is up to God. Hallelujah. He will destroy his own time. Bless Yeshua HaMashiach, who is soon to come back. Glory. Hallelujah. I give you all glory. I give you all honor. Now I give you all praise. Holy One of Israel, you are the lover, keeper, and sustainer of my soul. I long for the return of Yeshua HaMashiach, but I wait patiently for him. No one knows when he will return. He will come as a thief in the night. Still, should not become aware. Those of you who do not know Yeshua HaMashiach as your Mashiach, he's the Mashiach that was prophesied in the Tanakh. Those of you who have not accepted, accept it now, for the time is at hand. The great and terrible day of the Lord is at hand. The great and terrible day of the Lord is at hand. The great and terrible day of the Lord is at hand. The great and terrible day of the Lord is at hand. And who shall be able to stand? Those with a pure heart and clean hands who have not bowed their knees to Baal. Bless you, beloved children of the Most High. Amen.